Darwin's Markets shopping center car park turned multicultural foodie heaven in Malak. The scents of spices and other delicious fragrances fill the air as a band lulls the crowd, and fragments of foreign languages rise above the music. It is a sensory and cultural delight that at first glance might conjure a Melbourne alleyway, but this is the Malak Markets, a shopping center's car park which is transformed by food stalls every Saturday afternoon of the dry season. It offers a quick foodie jaunt around the globe, all from a camping chair under the alfresco sky. In a very small place you can travel the world, Syrian vendor Nadim Turkia says. If you want to know a culture, you should taste their food. All their culture you will find in their food. It's the United Nations of cuisine, with Syrian, Russian, Japanese, Spanish, African, Thai, Indonesian, Italian and French dishes simmering away. Photo: people can taste their way around the world without leaving the car park. ABC News, Christy O'Brien. Malak tries to set itself apart from other neighborhood markets by promoting itself as a clean, green, sustainable produce market, with all stalls putting ethical food production at the center of their business. We do things a bit differently to restaurants, says chef Martin Wildman, who runs a pop-up food van. I like to use what's local and seasonal and go direct to farms to see what I can buy that week and write a menu around that, and that's how we do things, modern creative. The humble weekend market has skyrocketed in popularity, with patrons seeming keen to enjoy the casual vibe while knowing exactly where their food is being sourced. Dave Thompson is a fourth-generation top-end grower, and says it's about changing people's mentality. That this doesn't travel 5,000 kilometers to get here, it travels 100 kilometers, it's a big difference, he says. It's on the day or the day before, the markets, we can't get it here any quicker, so it's good quality fresh fruit and veg. Markets, an example of Darwin's famous melting pot. Photo: Syrian immigrant Nadim Turkia runs a food van in Darwin and Palmerston. ABC News, Christy O'Brien. The success of Malak Markets has been threefold. It has put the small suburb on the map, it's raising the bar for Darwin's cuisine from the more standard pub grub, but perhaps most importantly, it is a perfect example of the multicultural melting pot that Darwin is famous for, making a new wave of immigrants feel part of this top-end town. Nadim Turkia migrated to Darwin from Syria last November, and has worked in restaurants since he was 13 years old. He says it means a lot to be able to share his Syrian heritage. We can show our culture to the people to show we are not terrorist people, he says. We are not searching for a war, we are just searching for peace, and that's the thing, why we create this here. It's a big change for us to come to Australia and to share our food, and they like it, accept it, that's a big thing. It mean a lot for us. Russian vendor Xenia Musica says cooking food from home makes her feel less homesick. You'll still be homesick, but at least you have the food to create hope to comfort you, she says. If the rate at which the food and drinks sell out is any indication, Darwin seems to be getting on board, with more and more locals making the trip to the northern suburbs lured by the cultural sensation. This story is part one in a series on Darwin's neighborhood markets. Check back in with us next Saturday to take a stroll through another suburb's offerings. Photo: a vendor stirs a pot at the markets, where many cultures meet over a shared love of food. ABC News, Christy O'Brien.